Сегодня вечером я бы хотел немножко рассказать о...
Today in the evening, I would like to tell you a few words about programming. Now, my presentation will be started.
Исторически так сложилось, что развитие
It is historically established that the development of computer engineering happens in frames of mechanical command execution. From the first calculating machines of Pascal and Leibniz to digital electronic computers of the first half of the 20th century. Based on these principles, the first computer languages appear. A program status and commands that can change the status lie as a base for them. This principle can easily be explained with the help of Felix calculating machine. A command here is happened when you press the lever or turn the handle of the lever of calculating machine. At the same time, the status that shows the dial changes. The result is final state of calculating machine. The first programs, which are written with the help of imperative languages, are continuous succession of commands. Everyone realizes that is their own way. That is the reason of the emergence of new idea. The complete chain of commands should be organized in blocks. In 1959, under the direction of Grace Hopper, procedural imperative language appears for the development of business apps. Around the same time, professor of MIT John McCarthy with Marvin Minsky are studying a problem of artificial intelligence. McCarthy feels the necessity of language that would fit the tasks which are solved in this field. In 1958, the first functional computer language Lisp is written. Lisp differs enormously from the languages of that time. Another paradigm lies at the heart of it. According to lambda calculation of Churchill, McCarthy brings in the idea of function in the language. Function, instead of procedure, has nothing to do with the main state of the program. Its result depends on parameters and results of other function calls. Such approach of program making has several advantages. Firstly, a function can restore another function. Such functions are called the functions of higher order. From programmer's point of view, it means that one has an ability to show the possibility of one task solving with the help of other task solving. This code is much easier to read. From compiler's point of view, it means that all calculations can be structured in the most optimal way. McCarthy says that when artificial intelligence starts working with people, stop noticing it. Nowadays, artificial intelligence is everywhere, from intelligent assistant in your mobile phone to compiler. A modern compiler optimizes the code better than the average programmer and does it better if it can make more changes in a program with no impact on its desired behavior. Here we come to the second crucial feature. If a function doesn't influence on the condition and doesn't depend on it, this function is called a pure one. Recalculation order with pure functions is not important. From compiler's point of view, it means that it can choose the desired strategy of calculation. For example, for maximum output. Let us consider an example. If a function is clear, its result for the given arguments can be saved in memory. And the saved result will be used when the function is opened next time. As a result, we have gain in efficiency. This approach is called memorization. The modern designers of software increase the number of computational cores of central processor. This leads to a situation that all and sundry more or less up-to-date desktop has between 4 and 8 concurrent data flows. Consequently, each more or less big software product consists of concurrent computations. It is a daunting experience if you try to imagine the difficulty that a programmer faces working with imperative language during concurrent program design. The presence of general condition. That's where the shoe pinches. Concurrent flows compete with each other in order to get access to it. This leads to the condition of pursuit. In the 70s of the previous century, a Canadian agency of nuclear power engineering shows a medical device for radiation therapy with a full programmed control. This gadget has three operating modes. Two regimes are with heavy X-radiation and one with the function of moving it to a diseased part of a body without radiation. There is a program error, which makes a program pursuit pursuit. The same variable is used not only for user input, but also for generic cycle of a program. Hence the device worked with heavy X radiation, showing no radiation regime on the screen. More than 11 people suffer from TRX 25. They get the heaviest dose of radiation, at least two died. I suppose that many programmers remember this case and will be careful with the general condition of a program and will not use global variables. Another crucial feature of operational approach is an ability to make declarative approach during code development. Declarative approach makes a programmer focus more on a problem and a desired result. At the same time, he or she focuses less on a way of achieving this result. As an example of declarative approach is a pure functional language and a packet manager NIX. All configuration is showed in declarative way and the packets look like values, which are operated by the functions in functional languages. Packets are combined by the pure functions without side effects and cannot be changed or rewritten. It gives an advantage in comparison with the traditional packet manager. Firstly, is the possibility of secure tracing of correlation. Packets and files in them are not stored in global environment. That means there is no dependence declaration. Secondly, it is a possibility of atomic update and back-off of changes. Because the packets are not written, there is always a chance to undo everything. In the second part, I would like to say a few words about the economy of robots. It is a classical scheme with feedback. The most vital element is pointed out with red color. AIRA provides an integration of economy in robot world. It forms a responsive economy of robots. It means that AIRA itself has to change. Let's have a good look at its structure. As we can see, AIRA consists of multiple modules or packets. Some of them have generic names. It means that they will be changing from task to task, providing the system with a reaction to external factors such as re-equipment of a factory with new manipulators or a change of market trends from red toothbrush to blue ones. Let's view a structure of AIRA changes. AIRA 0 is only come into the world. It does know nothing about the surrounding world. Era 1 has adapted the important packets and learned about circumference and markets. Era 2 generation reacts on a change of market trend to Mickey Mouse t-shirts, which are in high demand. Then the demand subsides, and Era 3 gets back to the production of traditional t-shirts. Here I need to emphasize the following. Robot economy is an economy of autonomic agents. Thus, the changes between configurations must be crystal clear for machines. This can be done by declarative approach, since the formal description of configuration is optimal for autonomic analysis and synthesis of future generations of Aira. And the possibility of back-off of changes an essential requirement for stable existence of autonomic system. Finally, I would like to quote an author and architect of the most popular Husky language. The unlimited mass of side effects observed everywhere is actually costing us more and more. Thank you for your attention.